evening we're going to do a bit of a failure analysis on a variable displacement piston pump removed out of an 8-ton Hitachi excavator. The owners and the operator said it was vibrating and making lots of noise. We did some pressure tests, wasn't generating much pressure, wasn't generating much flow for that matter either. So we pulled the pump out and we stripped it down, and this is what we found. Down here now. So this is the culprit. So this piston should look like that. Obviously it's failed, probably from thousands of hours of operation. What you see here is the remnants of one of these. Yeah, that's actually called a slipper, that's called the piston. This is called the valve plate. There's actually 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10 pistons in this pump. As you can see, these are very badly worn, so it's obviously creating lots of noise and vibration. And actually, these piston slippers actually run on this piece here, and you can actually see this groove that's been machined into this hardened steel plate. And this is called a swash plate, and this is what changes the displacement of the pump from high displacement to medium displacement to almost zero displacement. This is always constantly rotating. What this swash plate does is actually, when it's angled, it creates suction here. And as it rotates, it actually forces the pistons down and actually starts to create pressure. And depending on the angle, depends how much flow it'll create. So the barrel on this one is actually a little extra special. So it's actually, it has two discharges. It has an inner displacement. So five of the pistons all displace oil, but half the oil goes into these five slots, which come from these, every second hole here on the barrel. And then these external ones are from alternating pistons, the other alternating pistons. So when it hits the valve plate, this valve plate distributes the oil to either the left side of the pump or the right side of the pump. So you've got two pumps in one here with two separate discharges coming out of the pump. These are the bearings we removed from the swash plate. So all these parts are rebuildable. Obviously this we couldn't reuse. It had some very bad score marks from this bearing. So we put new bearings in. We put a new shaft in, even though the shaft's in good, reasonable condition. We put a new shaft, new bearing, new pistons, new barrel, new valve plate, new swash plate. There's actually a spring in here which we removed and reused on the new barrel, which actually keeps pressure on these pistons and forces them up against this swash plate.
Mm.